The start delay represents the time between the activation and the actual start of a task. This means it measures the time between the activation of the task until it is actually running on the core. This start delay is also visualized with this gray color. If you want to create a requirement for a start delay in the TA tool suite, you will need to go to the base part of the tool where you can find the requirements editor that will provide you this overview where you can select the task, the metric, limit, and the severity level of your requirements. So in this case, we want to create a start delay requirement for the task 1 millisecond. We search in the metrics for start and select the start delay. And we set our upper limit for the start delay for different severity levels. This will then later on, if you start a simulation or if you evaluate against a scheduling trace recorded on your hardware, show if a start delay higher than a certain level has been measured in the system. In the TA tool suite, you can now see the Gantt chart, which represents all your tasks running on the different cores in the measurement that you have done based on the hardware or in this example that you have simulated. It shows whenever a task was activated, when it had a start delay, or when it was preempted. Below here, you can find the process table. This process table is currently showing you the minimum, maximum, and the average start delay for the task 1 millisecond for which we defined a start delay requirement. You can already see here from this table that on average, the start delay is quite low and the minimum is very low, but it seems like there is at least one occurrence in this measurement which has a very high start delay of more than 1 millisecond, which is even exceeding the period of this 1 millisecond task. Let's now have a look at the requirements table. In this table, you see now the three requirements that we have defined, all based on the metric start delay for the task 1 millisecond with different severity levels, critical, major, and minor, for different limits. The critical value has been chosen with 0.5 milliseconds, which is half of the period of the 1 millisecond task. If you now drag and drop this requirement into the Gantt chart, you can see these red arrows popping up, and they always display when you had a start delay, which was higher than 0.5 milliseconds in this case. You can scroll around and find all the different start delays that caused this requirements violation to find out which of the tasks has been interfering with your 1 millisecond task here. To make it more easier to identify who interfered, you can activate the interference view. And now every time where you have interference, you will see these red lines, making it easier to find out which other task was interfering with the task 1 millisecond in this case. If you don't want to scroll around the Gantt chart all the time to find the violations, you also have the possibility to open up a histogram and drag and drop your requirement of interest into the histogram itself. You can now see the distribution of the occurrences of the start delay. And here you can see that the deadline at 0.5 milliseconds was not violated in many cases, but in some cases we had a start delay that was higher than 0.5 milliseconds. We will now have a look at the outliers in this case, so we mark them. So these are the occurrences where we had the most start delay. We mark them, we right-click, and we send this selection to the clipboard. Now you can find in the clipboard all the instances that violated this requirement and that were greater than 0.7 milliseconds. If you double click on one of these instances, you're directly jumping to the point in the Gantt chart where this this requirement violation happened. And with the help of the interference view, you can easily see that this task engine double R was interfering with your task 1 millisecond and caused this long start delay. You can now switch to all the other different occurrences of this high start delay. And you can now very easily see and find out that it's always the same task that is interfering with your task 1 millisecond causing this high start delay. At the end of this video, I want to offer you some possibilities to stay in touch and find out more about timing analysis. For that, I'm inviting you to join the LinkedIn group Runtime Analysis in AutoSAR Projects. In this group, you will meet other people working in this field, sharing their experiences and solutions for this topic. And you will, of course, also be able to engage in discussions and ask your questions there. Just search for the group directly on LinkedIn. Or if you want to have it easier, I put a QR code here in the video so you can simply scan the QR code and you will be redirected to this group. Would be happy to have you in the group. If you have questions to me directly or if you want to connect with me, I'm inviting you to scan the QR code here on the right. You can also see the link to my profile here on LinkedIn. I would be very happy to connect with you and answer any questions you have. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'm looking forward to stay in touch with you.